Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat sejahtera and good evening. Okay, we continue our class, Business Research Methodology. So, we are covered today on topic Mixed Methods Methodology, which is we also and still highlight the most important thing on the methodology qualitative, quantitative and mix. Okay, so we go through five examples, thesis. We go through five thesis doing mixed method methodology, so we can learn how to write in our methodology on topic is mixed method methodology. Okay, we straight away go to through the example number one. The topics: understanding and enhancing the development of entrepreneurial motivation undergraduate music students. Okay, so this the first thesis we need to go through. Okay, they start with the research design. Okay, they start with the research design. This research project's aim. So it depends lah, because in PhD and master. Sometimes we call that thesis, dissertations, projects. It depends actually lah, based on our study. Okay, in this thesis, they use on the research projects. Okay, this research project aim to understand the causal complexity and that leads to different motivational outcome by capture student experience and perspective in the education context. Okay, the case study approach is considered to be one of the key research design appropriate for the critical realist investigation which the project presents. So are a few scholar from Aston's, Wynn Jr. and Williams 2012 and Edward et al. 2014. Case study are highly capable and of facilitating the analysis of the complex settings and highlight contrastive positions. Okay, so other few support by authors, and then Hamilton and Corbett and refer to the case study approach as the one which aim to capture the complexity of relationship, belief and attitude with bounded unit using different form of data collection, and is likely to explore more than one perspective. So this one dia highlight beberapa scholar lah yang bersesuaian dalam case study, for example Hamilton and Corbett with theory. Okay, thus case study that wish to capture complexity and explore different perspective is best done through the use of multiple method with the bounded context. Okay, so in this their study using the case study, so they give the reason why or justification why they are applied and case study as the research strategy in order to answer their research question or research objective. Then continue for the next paragraph. While agree that using multiple methods, so in this topic actually we try to cover both and mixed method and multi method. I think that we have very clear, and in the first initial section we covered on what is the methodology. So I already covered that what is the research design, what the research philosophy. We differentiate 25 type different between quantitative and qualitative. So we have very good basic on this. So in this class, okay, purposely today specifically we go through on the mixed method. So while it's agreed to using this method, collect data with a bounded context in defining features of the case study approach, how to conduct case study is generally quite contested area with many different standpoint regarding its purpose. Okay, there's the proof lagi dengan beberapa scholar. There is no one perspective formula to follow, leaving the research to decide that will be the best fit among the different choice. Okay, if you notice in this study, okay, first thing first, they highlight that this case study benefits because can be involved in multiple perspective. Okay, so this one, there is no one perspective formula to follow. Meaning that, which is there to highlight that this case study that represent on qualitative research on the subjective matters. Okay. For the purpose of the research, it has been decided that rather than drawing on the case study as the method or methodology, it will be taken as the research approach. General, taking it as the approach mean that no set or method or methodology is dictated. Okay. Okay, this, I think that this scholar actually dia quite influenced dengan Hamilton and Kopitiam ni. So banyak dia ambil justification from these authors. Okay, next, the research can draw from the different theoretical doctrines as long as can be justified to fit the aim, the purpose of the research. Okay. Okay, from this matter kan, so kita nampak, we can see that this case study represent by this author from their thesis, highlight that case study also can be drawn from the different theoretical doctrine, meaning that they are follow the basic philosophy on the qualitative research. As the current, so from this slide, they suggest that study and single bounded case will more beneficial than study multiple case. So this one, dia tengok current research in exploratory nature. So exploratory in nature is quietly in deep on the qualitative research, suggest that study single bounded case will more beneficial study multiple case to allow for the more in-deep investigation to take place. So in this part is really important. That's why regarding the authors or the scholar you cite can represent the justified. So it depends. So this one from Hamilton and Kopitiam. So it's actually difference justified from, for example, case study from Robert Yin, from Habermas. So they have different arguments. Okay, this one argument from Hamilton. Okay, a single case, however, does not mean a single person. So there, if you want to study in case study, we have two. Case study, single case study and multiple case study. Okay, in this one, they give some basic definition. A single case, however, does not mean a single person and can refer to a single site or organization as long as the context of the study has the clear boundaries. Okay, be quite flexible. Okay, the selection of several contrasting case study, a single unit of study, for example, individual student with a university, along with multiple method of data collection, we provide sufficient assurance that information obtained, albeit as a single site, as a risk possible. So this is the beneficial if we can use the instrument of you can using the multiple method according to data collection and analysis. Okay. Case study can be also be conduct longitudinal over the extended period time for the repeat data collection to detect any changes that occur. So we notice that we can differentiate between time horizon. We have two, longitudinal and cross-sectional. So in this matter, in this thesis, they highlight that most related on longitudinal study. Okay, this not only contribute the reach of data, ini a term, this is a beneficial of the qualitative, memperkayakan richness of data, but will be useful of the research objective of capture change student engagement and perception over time. Critical realism in midway position at the paradigm spectrum, learning nature toward the positivism or quantitativism and the spectrum. So this one, positivism on behalf on the qualitative quantitative research, or constructivism. This one, something like constructivism is something like same like interpretism in the qualitative. Okay, so also grant research to freedom and justify to mix methods, and this can add yet another layer of reach of the assurance of triangulation. So this is applied also from this case, single case study, also we can apply for triangulation between different data types. Okay, therefore, the research design comprising a single case study. Okay. Now they conclude from the support, from argument, justification, from the suitable or relevant scholar. They finally conclude. Therefore, the research design comprises a single case study to be carried out over longitudinal period using mixed method. Okay, you can see so how that they are trying to same like Saunders. For if you still remember, Saunders have the six layer. So in this, first thing first, before they conclude this one, that's why they highlight that their study is case study, single case study. So they have to highlight the positivism, also blend with the constructivism or interpretism. So why they're using the mixed method? Because of triangulation methods. Okay. Okay, now, therefore, the research design comprised a single case study to be carried out over the longitudinal period using method has now been justified as the appropriate framework for guiding the choice method to use the project. The design can ensure that rich of data can obtain while fulfill the research objective set out in this project. The next session will turn toward the method that has been chosen in line with the research design as well as presented the case that will be studied. Okay, please remember this. Okay, this example. So before you highlight that you want to use mixed method research, before you declare you using mixed method research, you need to justify. You need to explain why you choose mixed method. Before you explain the mixed method, you need to clearly regarding on the philosophy and regarding our approach. And then the suitable research strategy. In this case, they're using the case study, specific single case study. Okay, so they highlight the beneficial of the qualitative richness data, more to flexibility, subjective methods, not exactly we need to test and follow only one theory. You should be flexible. So that's on that matter and justify, you should be can represent why this study more suitable to apply mixed method. Okay. The design can ensure that rich of data obtained while fulfill the research objectives of the project. The next session will turn toward method they have chosen in line the research design as well as present the case study be the study. Okay. Next, the go through. Okay. After they explain the research design 3.2.2. So the next they go through the explanation about the mixed method. So in this thesis also we can learn also to increase our knowledge and understanding about what is the mixed methods. Okay, two methods of data collection. One qualitative, so using the semi-structured interview. So we have three type interview. As the basically too easy to understand, we have structured interview, semi-structured interview, and unstructured interview. And one quantitative, they're using the questionnaire as the instrument. So in this case, they have using two instruments. First interview, second is questionnaire. Have been chosen as the tool to carry out this project. Due the exploratory that they also highlight in the research design, in the exploratory research nature of the study, the qualitative portion gains stronger, meaning that we know that this study is mixed method, but the dominant represent on the qualitative, more on qualitative research. Okay, portion gain the stronger emphasis while quantitative portion is supplementary, so support by quantitative. But the most important thing, is qualitative and quantitative is complement each other. The overall mixed methods design is therefore an embedded design in which the quantitative study framed by large qualitative study. Okay, we know that the mixed method should be involved in quantitative and qualitative, but the dominant in qualitative because this is exploratory. So that's why we know we can highlight on this also. So in this paragraph, you want to highlight, yes, for the mixed method, but the domination is from exploratory research by qualitative. Okay, this point is very important. And the study are independent each others, therefore we conduct separately. So however, there are converged point in interest which we'll discuss in the final chapter of the thesis. Okay, so they are separately. So for example, from objective, the true objective, if the objective number one is qualitative, then solved by process methodology in qualitative and also for analysis qualitative. And then for example, two also qualitative, third also qualitative, but number four is the quantitative. So meaning that you can solve your objectives separately by research in qualitative and quantitative, but finally, you should be discussed together how that this selection of methodology is more suitable and can explain in depth according to your specific objective. Okay, the qualitative study is largely responsible for unveiling the causal complexity involved, the motivational process to engage with entrepreneur. So this paragraph, they try to relate in their topics. The semi-structured interview was the method by which the main body of data were collected. In line with the longitudinal design, the three collection points were established across the space over the years, start, middle, and of the end of the years. To capture any change that took place, steered by critical realistance, Question will construct to capture subjective experience through the process and the elicit change. Further details about the interview process will be discussed later in subsection 3.4.3. Okay, the questionnaire method. So this one we can also, and if you are actually you are studying quantitative, you can get benefits from today's topics. Okay, because I'm trying to blend on the quantitative and the qualitative. So I know that this research, it should be integrated together quantitative and qualitative, but in order to understand the method, you can understand separately, because for example, in this paragraph is explained about the questionnaire. So in if you are research in quantitative study, you can also can get understanding and benefit from this thesis. Okay. The questionnaire method was used to embedded quantitative studies. In critical realist research, quantitative methods are more often used to identify and establish outcome pattern with a being set in close experimental context. So that the Shajaris, how to spell, Zakhariadis and et al. 2013. Okay, in this method, you can see that a critical realist research. In critical realist research is one of the philosophy. So philosophy, we have objectively realism, critical realism, kita ada interpretism, Pascal modernism, pragmatism. So in this research, they highlight using the in critical realist research on that quantitative. For the quantitative part, they're using the philosophy of the critical realist, atau we call that critical reality. Okay. The questionnaire method is especially adept at this. It can help to determine different similarities or pinpoint relationship between different variables that can get generalized to a population. Okay, so based on the Robson 2011. The quantitative study therefore focus and establish whether any factor relate to entrepreneurial development from the quantitative perspective. The study does not offer any causal explanation and therefore realize that qualitative study for deeper analysis of the outcome. Yes. Yes, this study, actually, we can see that a lot of the research when they are studying in quantitative always study on relationship, influence, effects. But this method, from this mixed method research, dominant by qualitative in this research, not study on the causal explanation or causal relationship. There are more and more exploration, domination by qualitative research. The main function of this study is to offer different perspective for the purpose of triangulation. So the procedure carried out the quantitative study we discussed in entirety in the next chapter. Therefore, no further detail we just present here. Okay, meaning that another reason why in this study also blend with the quantitative research, okay, in order to answer their objective, but the most important thing, try to increase the validity value by increase the numbers of instruments to be triangulation. That's why questionnaire needs in their studies. Okay. Okay, we go through example number two. Okay, from thesis number one, we can, as at least we can learn many things about methodology. So it's different actually if we refer research methodology books. Okay, some explanation maybe different. They try to go through detail, but in terms of the what we call that book narrative writing. Okay, but in this matter, we go through on thesis. So because we need to write a thesis, that's why we need to refer a thesis. We need to learn from the thesis, because we need to write. Before you write a thesis, you need to get the idea, you get the feeling, you get the idea, you get the structure, you get the way, you know that how to make sure that you can write in very good sentence in paragraph also, and go through outline and outline, go through chapter and chapter in order to complete one really good thesis. So that's why we need to refer thesis and thesis. Okay, we go through number two. This one, the topic is exploratory study of strategic visionary management of innovation, research and technology part officially with the universities. Okay. Number two is the start with the 4.2, because I'm selected sections in their thesis to discuss on the mixed method methodology. Okay, number one, they go through on the methodological approach. The concept of mixed method approach emerged during the 60s. It was the most preferred approach in several areas of knowledge like management. So this like sound like history lah. So they start with the 1960. So this one also subjective, is depend how that you need to meaningful your research. So in this matter, they are the highlight that the concept of meta approach emerged during the 1960s. Okay. There are some advantage that the research may benefit from by using mixed method. So this one straight away, yeah, they highlight that this research use the mixed method approach. So they give the reason why they're using the mixed methods. The most beneficial element of mixed method is that method provides scope of exploration as well as analysis. So these two terms, scope of exploration well as analysis. That's you are explore on research. You explore on the scope of research, and then you explore in analysis, meaning that you're using more on the research method and research analysis. Okay. Research that is based on the base method of research design start with the qualitative study, which helps the research to explore detailed knowledge relating to the main problem areas of the research. Okay. Okay, some if you study a book, you go through the experience, you get the knowledge from the thesis. Yeah, I'm agree. Most of the mixed method research, when we measure by numbers, when we quantify, yeah, a lot of research from qualitative. So they are blends, they are another support, they need support from the quantitative research, but still domination in qualitative. Okay. This is common. Okay. But still relevant, still have a few studies still use the mixed method, but domination in quantitative. No problem. Okay. So sometimes when I try to elaborate this thesis, I need to clarify also. So you get too situational and not just only agree 100% from the authors regarding the explaining their research. Of course, if you use study a mixed method, if you use using more on domination or qualitative, you need to highlight like this. If you study in mixed method but domination by quantitative, also you need to write another ways. But do you read, you write to show that the strengthen on your part of your research. Okay. All right. So continue research that are based on the mixed method of research design that start with a qualitative study, which have research explore or detailed knowledge relate the main problem area of the research. After gain detailed knowledge on the main research problem, the method influence the research to conduct the analysis by employing quantitative data qualitative tool like survey. Okay, in this method also, they give the some introduction in first paragraph to highlight that, yes, this study using mixed method, but domination by exploration using qualitative research, and then support by quantitative. So this second thesis also, we can see that domination by qualitative and support by quantitative. Okay, continues. Okay, apart from the, and I go through, apart from this, the mixed method approach help the research to conduct the study from the broader perspective. The case of the single approach, the research can concentrate in a particular issue, only try to identify cause-effect relationship between research variable. However, in case of the mixed method of the mixed research approach, so we have two, kita ada mixed method and mixed research. Okay, the overall scope of the research is analyzed from the broader perspective. Okay, kita tengok another one good scholar. Okay, Ted Lee and Tasha Corey argue that there are several issues adapting mixed method as the research approach. I need a very good citation. The major challenge is identify the proper research design. Okay. If you want to apply the mixed method from the Teddy and Tasha Corey highlight, you face the difficulty in order to highlight and then, regarding to propose your research design. That the first issue, when the researcher need to apply this method, the first challenge and obstacle is how you design your research. Okay. All right. Then, therefore, Leach and Onwood Boozy, and mention the right name. Okay. From Leach and Onwood Boozy, okay, come up with the three-dimensional typology research, the issue of research design. The first thing first is level mixing, a level of mixing, partially mixed versus fully mixed. Okay, this is the partial mix, this is the fully mixed. First, We call that level of mixings. Yang kedua is about the time orientations. Second is time orientations is concurrent versus sequential. I mean that your research, if you are follow in your objective, sequential meaning that quali, quanti, quali, quanti, or quanti, quanti, quali, quali, quanti, something like that, or concurrent. Every objective should be covered both. So objective number one, concurrent. We have quanti and quali. Objective number two, also concurrent. We apply an instrument from quanti and qualitative also. Every question using mixed instrument and mixed method, we call that concurrence. Okay, so number two, from first thing first, they declare how to differentiate between mixed method, or you want to know the type. Type number one is about the level of mixing, partial or fully. Number two is about the concurrent or sequential. Number three is emphasize approach equal status versus nominal. So equal is quite balanced. Equal meaning that balance. So I'm apply, balance, quali and quantitative. But sometimes we discuss on mixed method, who the dominance? Qualitative on quantitative. This one, Dottedi and Toshokori. So this, a lot of the scholar, your supervisor or your research, a PhD student also get this knowledge. So this is a very good citation. So everyone, I hope so, you can get this one. So in order to clear what is mixed method, this based on Dottedi and Toshokori, we have three. Based on number one, level of mixing. Level mixing meaning that this is a partial or the fully mixed method, or two is about the time construct, time orientation, is about concurrent or sequential, and number three regarding on the emphasized approach, equal balance or the versus on the dominance status. So if you need to write in the mixed method, so this is quite popular citation from the Dottedi and Toshokori. Another disadvantage in the mixed method is the level complexity which must higher. So this one highlight the complexity. Okay, complexity always sometimes not discussed on from this method. I'm not agree the word using another disadvantage, because you should be know that if you apply mixed method, you are go to the complex research. You face the complex process, complex analysis. This is the part of the mixed method. So I'm not fully agree the words of another advantage use that words. Okay, the mixed quantitative and qualitative method increase the complex level of this approach. Okay, it's common. If you apply the mixed method, you face a complex of research. Okay, from the Humarita Peltomaki and Numela 2006, conducted through investigation of the most preferred research approach. And the study revealed that the mixed method approach has the lead over the qualitative method. So in this part lah, they highlight that if you study mixed method, you should be higher the level from basic or the pure of the qualitative. The significant argument Olson 2004 research that the data analysis, the different data collection method should be smooth and should not conflict with each other. In my opinion of views, I'm not agree citation like this. If you do research, don't blame a method. Don't blame the method. So qualitative is more good compared in qualitative. Qualitative is more good compared in qualitative. It should be go to the specific based on your how to answer your objective and research question. If your question, your research objective and research question like this, the most suitable methodology in quanti, so you need to follow the process of the quantitative research. Is more suitable on the qualitative. That's why you need to apply and qualitative method and analysis. It's more suitable regarding more complexity. You want to be intelligence research. You want to get the intelligent methods. You want to be covered triangulation, cover a lot of instruments, because you believe that the increase of instrument will be increase your validity. And more specifically, are more relevant and suitable to answer your research objective. That's why we apply the mixed method. Okay, so this the research elected use mixed method to achieve 5 outcomes. So this is the 5 outcomes from the mixed method. Number one is about triangulation. A lot of discussion on these methods. Or if you are study mixed method, another the point that the people or the evaluator always highlight regarding triangulation. That nearly meaning that, oh, okay, you apply mixed method. We already know that most of the mixed method research will be applied triangulation, meaning that use the three three instruments. For example, interview, observation, survey. So you use three instruments that we call that triangulations. Okay, number two is felicitations. By using quantitative research, strategy of survey help generate a main hypothesis and measurement for the qualitative method. Okay, I'm agree that point. And facilitation. So some research which we need to know that the philosophy and approach. That in quantitative, you need to test a theory. So you need to objectively, you need to test a theory and you need to test hypothesis. We need hypothesis in order to identify the determine the causal or the measure of relationship, influence or effects, either direct or indirectly. So the most important thing, we need theory and hypothesis to be test. That the nature of philosophy and approach of quantitative research. Okay, but in these two research strategy that we already explained last week or last two, three weeks, we discussed on this. In qualitative research strategy, we have two research strategy which is can be accepted. Okay, can be applied this. For example, case, you know, example, mostly in these two. Case study and initial research. So that's why they put point is some of study in quantitative, qualitative also use a survey on the quantitative, but can be deeper in research study, case study and initial research. Okay. Complementary. So this always, when we talk about the mixed method, is complementary. Complementary, we need quanti and quali. We need approach inductive from quali, we need approach deductive from quanti. So we need positivism, at the same time we need interpretism. We need case study and we need a survey, something like that. Okay. So using quantitative data collected method, survey to fill in the gap, analyze relationship between, so they covered on their topic, the RTP government model and the performance and growth rate using interview and multiple case study provide explanation of the hypothesis. Okay, so they're using the case, multiple case study. And then in multiple case study, they have, maybe they use document, interview and observation. Plus, we need to support on the survey on quantitative. Generality, okay, before that, please remember in quantitative, we have two research strategy, survey and experiment. Generality, the quantitative data collection method survey was employed as the independent source and the collection context. The qualitative method, case study, interview in order to set broader context generalization of the research. Okay, the reason one, okay, in qualitative, very basic, I need to explain the basic. In qualitative, purposely, you want to study more to specifically on that context or settings. But in quantitative, because they use the survey and questionnaire, they can be sent more to generally. So they can answer the generally by proof by result on significantly, for example. Okay. And then the last kali is aid interpretation. So use quality data collection method, aid explanation relationship between quantitative variables in research study to answer the main question. There is correlation between this one. So the most important thing why this study apply the mixed method because of triangulation issues, felicitation, complementary, generality and the interpretation. So to increase the interpretation, we need apply both quantitative and qualitative. So this highlight beneficial or to aim to achieve 5 outcome if they are study, if they are apply on the mixed method research. Okay, Richard et al. 2003 state that mixed method are crucial in examining both quantify and quality of the single phenomena. It's very good definition actually. Okay, yes, from the one single phenomena, so we have quantify, we need that quantitative research. And quality is qualitative research. So this is one of that 25 we compare the before class, previous class. So highlight 25 difference between quantity and quality is part of the quantity and quality. Okay, this one support also from Ritchie et al. 2003. In some case, it's very complex to study one side of phenomena with the statistical measurement and there is significant need to study phenomena. So it's very complex if you want to study single mono method in quantity. So we need to solve this single phenomena using only quantitative. It's quite difficult because it's not easy to explain in that situation. That's why we need to support another method to blend in quantitative, which is we need to blend quantitative and qualitative. Therefore, this research undertake two exploratory studies using different type information and measurement. So this one they relate, yeah, their study. Okay, we go through example number three. Okay, academic entrepreneurship and academic career and multi-dimension analysis in the UK, Australia, and Italy. Okay, I'm sorry, Ian, if you can see that I try to give example more on management topic, a few example on the entrepreneur, but same time I still relate on the education. So because we in UPSI, a lot of the student, yes, they are study in management, they are study on business, but they are still some of the research or students try to apply on the education. So that's why they choose UPSI for their further study. So that's why I'm trying to the topic on education another issues. But we need to discuss on the methodology. But don't afraid. Okay, don't afraid. Or you mentioned on unrelated. So all the these thesis I try to give the example is related in order to make sure you are clearly crystally clear understand what is the mixed method research. Okay. Okay, we go through number three. They start with the philosophical assumptions. Okay. We regard nowadays a useful research approach, a debate is still open among scholars regarding philosophical assumption underpinning mixed method and the relationship between method and their pragmatic foundation. Tashakuri Tadli. This is one of the scholar yang saya punya, saya suka lah. If I read a mixed method, then this is one of the book that I need to read. So because Tashakuri explain more to the realistic. Realistic meaning that we can understand, we know that. So this is a part of the complexity and challenge doing a mixed methods. This view are broadly presented an embedded method. So we have sequential, we have embedded, we have concurrent, okay? To support the very basic explanatory or exploratory research. Okay, this is by Bryman. So Bryman, another top scholar also, to represent qualitative or mixed methods. The former suggests that qualitative and quantitative research method cannot be adopted with the same research because they are different epistemological and ontological foundation. Yes, I agree. That's why before we confirm that our research strategy is single or mixed or multiples. So that's why we need to cover philosophy. We need to cover our approach, and we need to cover our option and our choice. The most important thing is about philosophy and approach. That's the words that the difference between. So how that you need to explain your ontology, epistemology, and ontology based on the reality of knowledge. How you develop, how you extend that knowledge based on the research, what the contribution, the value from that research, that the part of the ontology, epistemology, and ontology. We already covered on this, the first week that the topic we cover on research methodology. Okay, they refer the two different incompatible view of the world and phenomena under study. Similarly, a paradigm. So paradigm, we have five very basically. We have positivism, interpretivism, or constructivism. We have critical realism. So the postmodernism, then we have the pragmatism. So mixed method mostly, it's not mostly like always using the philosophy on the pragmatism. Okay. Similarly, pragmatism argument conceive of qualitative and quantitative research as paradigm in which epistemological assumption, values and method are expressly intertwined in incompatibility between paradigms. Okay, this is one from the Bryman. Okay, while these views still appear in the literature, various authors have tried to make peace between a major pragmatism position. So ada a few lah, Mazina and Cameron. One attempt by mine, this is from the Cook and Wilberforce. The author contend that is no intrinsic link between a paradigm and a method, and different methods can be combined with the same study. Okay, we cannot use. Okay, I use that, for example, I use the inductive approach. So in inductive approach, we can apply mixed method, cannot be. So if you using inductive, meaning that you use the qualitative research. If you use the deductive approach, meaning that the quantitative. You cannot say that I'm use that deductive, so I can apply both. I can using qualitative and quantitative, cannot be. If you want to do a mixed method, you should be blend two approach and two philosophy, at least as a minimum. If you want to study mixed method, your philosophy should be positivism and interpretivism, at least two. One from quali, one from the quanti. So your approach should be blend your inductive and deductive. You cannot using only one approach and one philosophy, but suddenly you choose a research strategy, a mixed method. Okay, that the highlight. Okay, that's why they did that, try to explain. That's why research is important. Research design is really important. Why we need to clear your philosophy and approach before you decide your study on the mixed methods. In this perspective, the mixed method approach is considered a method for data collection. The single paradigm approach, instead a pragmatism, specific philosophical reference for the mixed method approach. Okay, from the Tashakuri, Tetley, side in Tashakuri Tetley, same people lah, but different years. This philosophical approach support the positivity combining qualitative and quantitative. When they're using a pragmatism philosophy, that proves that this philosophical pragmatism suitable to combine both in quantitative and qualitative of a choice of the research strategy. Okay, sorry, choice of research. Okay, next. Combining qualitative and quantitative method and data with the same study is necessary to answer your research question. Okay, whatever you do in your methodology, and in chapter 2 also, whatever you do in chapter 2 because you want to answer your research objective and research question, and chapter 3 also, whatever you do, whatever you plan, whatever you apply, whatever from your research activity and process, why you do this, why you do that, because to answer your objective and research question. In practical terms, this approach advocates for the adoption of what works from Molina Azorin in relation to the specific focus, the aim of the study. The reasoning behind the pragmatism view is that there are singular and multiple realities that an open empirical inquiry and orient itself towards solving practical problems and the real world. Pragmatism thus conceives the world characterized by different from realities toward which research may assume the multiple lens that the best suit the difference of reality with the aim to resolve what the reality bring to attention. So in this matter, actually try to highlight the matters of that ontology, epistemology, and ontology. It's about how that your research extension, about your knowledge, about your reality, about that contribution. And so when you want to make it chosen whether use the mono, multi, or mix. So this part of the philosophy and approach you need to discuss before you decide. Okay. Pragmatism is often considered a philosophical partner. This is another scholar mentioned lah, philosophical partner. And not necessary yet, you need to write a lot of things, mixed matter. When we read your thesis, it's not a research design, but they explain the definition mixed method too over lah. For me, sometimes it should be related. Whatever the definition, whatever you need to explain the concept of mixed method, I think should be moderate and humble. That is actually try to strengthen and then try to prove that mixed method is suitable and give the right and relevant justification only. Not necessary to write a lot of justification, but the meaning is still redundant. Okay? Pragmatism is often considered a philosophical partner and of mixed method research and ultimately the philosophical stand underpinning the present study. However, that's com. One about the facts that the mixed method do not operate on the basis of any theory, agree vision, pragmatism, and such philosophical position may assume four assets which provide justify for different vision and use a mixed method. For practical limitation, It's not possible here to explain in more detail barrier-space pragmatism. It is important, however, to explain that the present study use of mixed method was underpinned pragmatism stand to provide a basic for using mixed method in a as a third alternative, and that is when the use of qualitative and quantitative method alone or not sufficient to answer the research objective. Okay, so they try to explain many angle, many perspective. But the most important thing, I'm interested the last point to qualitative or quantitative method alone are not sufficient to answer your research objective. So this another reason lah from the book Tasha Corey and Creswell lah. Why they highlight this? But you need to read all the keyword and explain the present study a mixed method was underpinned by pragmatism. So if you're using a pragmatism, that the best suit is you need to apply mixed method to answer your objective. When you apply pragmatism as your research philosophy. Such an approach was a study driven by the different nature of research question which require different method of investigations. With the same research project with overall applied orientation in the study, another typical features of the method approach. Okay, so meaning that if your objective, the numbers of your objective cover the different perspective and for the data collection and research approach, so you need to apply a mixed research, which is mixed method or multi methods. The said mixed method is the unique strategy. Qualitative and quantitative method may be used combined in various ways, depend on the sequential given one or other component and priority the weight in the study. Ini Creswell lah. So Creswell, they assume that mixed method is a unique strategy. Qualitative quantitative method is combined in the various way. Yeah, qualitative go through in qualitative way, quantitative in quantitative way. So that's why if you study a mixed method, if you objective number one is quanti, then you solve that from the qualitative research. You just do qualitative research because objective number one is a qualitative. That you use your own way. If you are quantitative, please answer this question on objective through on the research process on quantitative. If the concurrent meaning that apply both in one objective, you have quality and quanti, please solve together. Meaning that you using the qualitative for the right way for the research and quantitative the right way. But if to explain, to discuss, for interpretation, you need to combine. Okay? The following session report explains about the specific strategy adopted the present work. Okay, so this one, what we call that, the types of the mixed method. One of the type of the mixed method, we call that sequential explanatory mixed method. So different scholar, they have proposed different types. For this one is very basic in general. So we have triangulation design mixed method. We have exploratory mixed method. We have explanatory mixed method. We have a sequential explanatory mixed method. We have sequential exploratory mixed method. We have embedded mixed method. We have concurrent mixed method. We have transformative mixed method. So we have different scholars, they have proposed different type of the mixed method. So in this case, they use the sequential explanatory mixed method, meaning that explanatory domination more on quantitative. A sequential explanatory is domination by quantitative and support by qualitative. Okay, the present work adopted sequential explanatory mixed method approach, starting the data collection with the quantitative elements and continue with qualitative. Most of the sequential explanatory start with quantitative. Okay. However, the priority does not imply higher weight of one part other as equal important was given quantitative. So dia ada highlight lagi, Tash Gary. So macam saya cakap tadi, if you study sequential explanatory, should be dominant by quantitative. But in this case, they cite Tashokori and Tedley. Tashokori also highlight, not necessary. If you study sequential explanatory, yes, you need to start by quantitative, but necessary is about nomination. You can be equal, then sometimes you can apply for the nomination. You can be partial and fully mixed method. So this, they are follow the definition by Tashakori and Tedley. If you say that a sequential explanatory by domination by quantitative, not 100% right. Because Tashakori and Tedley highlight also, you can use sequential explanatory, but for this purpose can be equal. Not necessary domination by quantitative. Okay. This is very good knowledge. With the quantitative analysis, the study aimed to analyze the extent which certain individual variable were predictor of academic entrepreneurial behavior. Ini they highlight from their topic. The follow qualitative analysis help explaining why certain variable were not significantly predictor, along with providing further information on the IDPD process. This is very good because we can know that from the explanatory, we can start from the quantitative. So why we need quali? If you can solve a quantitative, why we need quali? Because qualitative analysis help explaining why certain variable will not significantly predict. Why? We cannot answer why. We always can answer what. In order, what, when, who. This is a quantitative. But to answer why certain variable not significant predictor can be support by qualitative research. Okay. Okay. Particular qualitative investigation aim to help light on how academic themselves perceive and experience the possibility involvement entrepreneurial activity. So this one, they are related in your topics. Okay, which the meaning attribute to such activity. Furthermore, while quantitative analysis was also done in contact fashion, the qualitative analysis sought provide further deeper insight and aspect. So this one complement each other. So you're using quantitative, but we need to support in qualitative also. Okay, particularly the effect the proximal context, university environment, and the distal context. This one a meso level for university environment and distal context for macro level. At the national context, we expect to explore the interview. Okay. In so doing, the mixed method approach aim to provide complementary. So this one lah. Macam tadi kan, dia ada a few kan, reason. Complementary, facilitation, triangulations, they have the reason. So this, from grid, they become complementary. So, it depends lah, it depends. So this thesis highlight 5, this thesis maybe highlight only 1. To measure overlap, but also different pace of the phenomenon underlying enrich, memperkayakan elaborated understanding and that phenomena. Okay. The qualitative analysis also sought investigate how it was connected scientist career. The study focused providing insight into how career interest and the orientation influence academic willing to engage entrepreneur why besar. Ini dia meaning that dia refer their topic. Okay. While quantitative component investigate some of career related issues such as analysis which specifically aim to estimate the impact. Okay, attitude that extend to which academic engage entrepreneur activity. The interview sought information on the subjective. Interview sought information on subjective meanings attribute entrepreneur activity on how this will perceive influence from the career. Such analysis can divide expansion. Okay, where the qualitative and quantitative method are used to extend the breadth and range inquiry using different method for different inquiry components. Okay, so in this last paragraph, meaning that they try to highlight from their study on entrepreneurs, so how that is, why they need to apply quantitative and quantitative using both to answer their objective and research question. Okay, given, however, present the complementary purposes as earlier discussed, it would most appropriate to talk about higher order expansion design. Okay, where the overreach strategy was an expansion one with the with element to study include the instant development. Okay, because the quantitative result used purposefully select interview according to certain criteria. Okay, the procedure defined participation selection models. Okay. Okay, the selections of the interview on the basic result, a survey also constitute one the main point of connection integration between two components of the study. Okay, defined by Ebenkova, Creswell, Ebenkova et al. Okay, the other two connection point to beginning the study where the scope of defined research question and design. The final discussion phase when the finding of the entire study elaborate integrated. Okay, ni another point lah. While this thesis report separate analysis interpretation, so they are highlight regarding the mixed method, while thesis report separately analysis and interpretation for both quantitative, see chapter 5 and qualitative, chapter 7 and interpretation. This is something like direction from their thesis, also provide overreach view of the studies. Okay, such integration strategy has been defined contiguous approach because the data from two stand are analyzed and interpreted separately section. And if you are actually analyzed and interpret separate, we call that contiguous approach. And sequence compared integrated at inferential stage. Okay, so this is another explanations regarding on the mixed methods based on the cross-country sequentials explanatory means method, because this study using sequential explanatory means method, we can see the what we call the figure 4.1. So they start with the quanti start first, then next quali. So by sequential, next one equal quanti. So they are study from three countries, from UK, Australia, and Italy, but they start with their research and doing a quantitative first. That's why the sequential explanatory. But in this research, based on their explaining or research design, it should be equal and for the part of the qualitative and quantitative. Okay. So this one, approach allow within method quantitative comprise between the groups. Okay. Within method inter and intra group qualitative comparison, and then cross method comparison among group combined. Okay, after you get the data from different countries, you can compare the analyze. You know the study, the comparative study, but actually you compare their result. Okay, while the variety or interview combine the strategy adopt may seem as the intricate and complex way conduct research, it must be acknowledged that this is not a rare in this method study, which ultimately are often underpinned by variety of purpose. Okay, single or pure approach in the facts will be have not fit with the multi-scope orientation present. At the same time, it must be acknowledged that notwithstanding useful a mixed method in this work and by this scholar and in Vancouver despite that popularity and straightforwardness, the mixed method design is not easy to implement. Challenge were indeed encountered by research while conducting the project. That's why I am from the example from the thesis number one, always the term that used when you apply or you conducted in mixed method is complexity. It's not easy that we face a challenge and obstacle, but it's actually also have the beneficials. And when you actually combine and this both quantitative and qualitative. So this part discussing on ethics, okay? Ethic approval was obtained from University of Birmingham. So at this university also in Malaysia also always, if you want to collect data, you need to settle from the ethic box to get the permission before you go to data collection. Okay. Before commencing the data collection, the study adhere to university ethical procedure throughout. So we need to go through our university ethical procedure. So this same also face in Malaysia. Okay. Following the guidelines, such as the business and management research, and both was voluntary. For all participation in study, consent was sought with providing from the science books and beginning the survey for the interview. Okay, when we see for the overseas practice, so for example, in university, we have faculty, because faculty will be clear, understand on your fields. So based on your faculty, they have department. So specific department, the first person approval from the research ethic is from the department. So department approves that the research is suitable because follow the research ethics. Finally, there can be proof by universities. By university also, they will have special board. On behalf of that special board, that board will be recognized and to confirm that you achieve your ethics consideration. So we have two level. One level under a department or faculty, another level is from universities. Okay, participation will inform beforehand the study aim to procedure. So this is really important. Eh? So your respondent should be volunteer. They can give me commit. So they agree this matter, the procedure. That's why we need to a very good discussion. A little bit form need to science before you do the research. Okay. The data collection self maintain confidential and privacy. So this paragraph actually discuss on the ethics. Okay, the survey was conducted using research qualitative personal account that was securely protected through password that only researcher can could access the data. Some when you get the questionnaire sets, some set questionnaire is easy, you can get from the article journal in the part of the appendix. So some the questionnaire you get from the books, research books. Some you need to buy the questionnaire to using that the instrument survey. So some that they have the controlling and monitoring the questionnaire. But the most important thing is about the intellectual property. Some of the instrument have copyright. If they are copyright, the C symbol. So if their questionnaire is copyright, you need to get the permission to use that questionnaire before you use. Okay, is in terms of law, if you use that questionnaire, before you get the permission from the original author, which is you are wrong actually. And okay, in terms of legal, you make it wrong because before you use, you need to be efficient. That's why some of NISTI and some of NISTI, if you want to use that questionnaire, they provide a form. They provide a form that you need to send the form to the original authors. So need original author need to verify and sign, for example, to prove that give the permission use that questionnaire. Okay. Okay, we go through number four. Okay. Research method approach. Let's start with the research method approach. The most frequent use qualitative method was semi-structured interview. Okay. Not only mixed method. If you are studying pure qualitative, also should be semi or unstructured interview. So the quite openness. So you can get enrich the data and like explanations. Okay. Okay, better was semi-structure, case study and secondary data will most frequently use a quantitative method in the self-complete questionnaire survey. A social media study is not surprised. Okay, so this is good. Before you explain a lot or you explain in deep what a mixed method, the first thing first, you highlight that on social media study, already a few study covered on mixed method. Okay, you need to generally you start with the initial explanation. For example, in this thesis, highlight the social media study. It's not surprising that semi-structured interview approach are more domination questionnaire because of nature emerging on social media. So they justify the reason why semi-structured interview approach are suitable on their research. So there are quite numbers of scholar here. Underline the value qualitative research, highlight the rich detailed discussion, compact phenomena and advantage flexible tools of investigation. So the keyword on the complex phenomena and flexible that represent on the words on the qualitative research. This provide more robust context in which quantitative data can be interpreted. So we be supported by quantitative to be robust. So we actually robust. That's why sometimes case study, their concept of case study, which is they are mixed method because they have robustness and rigorous and robustness. Rigorous is actually more to qualitative and more to detail in deep. Okay, but robustness lasa is always is on the quantitative. When you are blend antara robustness and rigorous, it's become complement each other. Okay. There's also evidence that research choose questionnaire survey as their quantitative research method to deal with different research questions. Okay, rooted in empirical sociology research, quantitative survey method seem well suited to investigate social psychological factor involved in user acceptance of technology system. Okay, next paragraph, Scarf and Bellinger 2014 found that methodology approach is answering the research question as determined value social media is more mistress. So this one specific, but most of researchers agree why you choose this selective methodology approach because you want to answer objective and research question. But this from the Scarf and Bellinger specifically on the field on the social media to small business. For the purpose comparison of this literature, semi-structured interview will be applied with this study to deal with similar research objective and research question to investigate the nature of social media. Okay. They're using the exploratory sequential mixed method. So exploratory sequential, maksudnya bergilir. So they're using explore, meaning that more on qualitative. From this, for basically we can know that exploratory domination on qualitative, explanatory dominant by qualitative. But still remember, a few scholars also they have different definition to represent on the exploratory and explanatory, which is the term using dominant or some they use the research using equal. By allow legitimizing the use of mixed method, postmodernism allow flexibility in research design. For example, interview protocol may be structured or semi-structured and the data analysis follow specific pattern in order to transparent with any explanation based on the collected data. This one from the GAS 2013. This study adopt sequential exploratory strategy mainly because of this is the reason why they're using a sequential exploratory strategy. Okay, because of expected outcome that clearly to develop good measure and that you use to measure the outcome in the survey project. Okay, the study sub-examine the social media situateness with the business context, begin the exploratory qualitative first. The first phase is a qualitative from the exploratory. Okay, from the interview, SME owner management manager in Malaysia the reason for adopting qualitative stage in the two fields, two form, sorry. While technology is rapidly changed, important to explore the nature and the change. So they need to explore the nature. Number two is identify the key factors and impact of the social media adoption and SME and generate item to develop measures. So these are two reasons why they are adopting qualitative. First, because of to explore the nature. Second one, to identify the key factors and impacts. The qualitative approach is appropriate with this study is aimed to explore use affordance outcome in constantly changing environmental technology. From qualitative thematic analysis, the data, then extensive review of the literature can be performed to determine appropriate measure by qualitative finding. So this one for the thematic and qualitative synthesis in the literature review. Okay. The intent of the exploratory strategy is develop a better measurement with specific samples or population to see if data from few sample qualitative phase and generalize of large sample. So specific or few sample is actually qualitative phase, but for the large sample is about on a quantitative phase. The qualitative data is also we use to develop hypothesis that can be tested using, okay. This is really good. This statement is really good. And the qualitative data is also will be used to develop hypothesis that can be tested using quantitative phase. Okay. Qualitative is actually generating hypothesis, generate hypothesis. But quantitative is testing the hypothesis. That's another words to better explaining why qualitative is hypothesis generate, why quantitative is hypothesis testing. Because this one. This one another sentence that represent the same thing. And so if you develop hypothesis because you can propose on that because you study on qualitative, but for the quantitative you need to test the hypothesis. The initial field qualitative and data collection was connected subsequent quantitative measure because sequential quali and so subsequent apa a measure to regress testing for score ability and arbiter. Okay, the study for the quantitative phase, a second phase, quantitative follow the qualitative phase and the quantitative phase should be state the development and measure. The emphasis of project forward quantitative research and study could be point toward the survey and recognize the research come up the technology industry, strong quantitative orientation and the study makes sense. The design may or may not be implemented with the implicit theoretical perspective. The process of this mixed method design is applied in the current research. So this is adopted from the Creswell figure 1-2. So they explain the exploratory sequential mixed method. They start with the qualitative. So qualitative, they have interview that they have the data analysis, inductive data analysis. So next, second phase, is quantitative, they have survey and analysis. The last one, you make it the interpretation. So this drawing figure exploratory sequential mixed method design is adapted from Creswell 2014. Okay, generally, the choice of research method depends on research problems that is investigated as well as research background and the audience it address. And this one from the Creswell 2014 also. They use qualitative and quantitative method allow the reach to more through the comprehensive understanding. The word is more true on comprehensive understanding. So if you want to, general understanding, which is represent on quantitative. General understanding, quantitative. Okay, if you want to in deep understanding is qualitative. But if you want to more comprehensive understanding is a mixed method. Okay. All right, the purpose of the strategy is the use of quantitative data and result to assist interpretation of qualitative finding. Okay, from the Morgans, suggest that this design is appropriate to use when testing element emergent theory result from the qualitative phase and can also be used generalized qualitative finding. So, kekurangan, the lacking of quantitative will top up on the qualitative. Lacking on qualitative can be covered on the quantitative research. Similarly, Creswell also highlight the same thing. Cite one purpose for selecting this approach to determine distribution of phenomena with the chosen population. So, chosen population, a few sample and from population represent on qualitative, the large sample represent on the quantitative research. Integrating mixed method, The study illustrates how different methods were integrated into one study in order to facilitate a deep understanding of technology adoption. Following a sequential design, the study consists three phase adapted the three level of understanding from Lee. In attempt to integrate positivism and anthropism from research philosophy, Lee proposed that framework in which different research paradigm consists in order to facilitate interactive development of integrated understanding. Okay, this one, they have come up the tables. Okay, you can see the table 5, project phase, level understanding and research method. So phase 1 is based on literature review the development. So level 1 is subjective understanding, research method dia literature and discipline review. Phase 1 literature review, phase 2 qualitative. Qualitative interview, conduct in-depth interview with respondent. This is the project phase number 2. So the level understanding is interpretive understanding. The level is, if literature review, the subjective understanding. If you're using qualitative interview in-depth, we call that interpretive understanding. So this one, individual interview. So phase number 2, using the survey and quantitative survey, quantitative is because that positivism understanding is from the quantitative survey. So from this thesis, what we can learn? Because the differentiate the level of understanding based on the project phase. If you are literature review, it's we call that subjective understanding. If you use in-depth interview, it's the interpretive understanding. If you're using survey in quantitative, we call that positivism understanding. Okay, so we have research method. If you use survey, questionnaire. If you in-depth interview, can use individual interview. So in a literature review for the subjective understanding, you use literature and the discipline review. Okay, so this is part the explanation, the go through. So this one project phase kan, the phase 1, phase 2, phase 3. So you can read in this slide. So how they're explaining the phase number 1, literature review. Okay, level number 2, they're explaining on the qualitative interview. And phase number 3, they explain on the quantitative survey. Actually, it's quite same. So we go through thesis by thesis, but you can self-read in this slide to mostly clear on regarding these three phase. Phase number 1 in the literature review, phase number 2 from the in-depth qualitative interview, from number 3 from the survey, from the questioning. Okay, so this approach also can come up with this table to answer your objective and research question. For example, their objective to understand a social media adoption, research question, how to social media has affected. So they apply both quantitative and quantitative. This we call that concurrent. And because they're using both two. To examine the social media, what are the outcome the technology afforded? This we have, they start with the qualitative, but because they're exploratory sequential, they need to start the qualitative by support by quantitative. But the last one, to test, develop and test framework, what are the significant factors? They're using single quantitative. Okay, so this part we call the exploratory sequential mixed methods. Okay, so this another example from number 5. Actually, they become the selective. Okay, you can study yourself to make it you understand on the mixed method research. Okay, I'm just cover until number 4. The last example number 5, you can refer directly. So little bit same, a little bit different. So you can to increase your understanding. So in order to increase understanding, you can refer the number 5 examples thesis. Okay, please do yourself to increase your level of understanding. Please read a lot of thesis to know that what is the research methodology. You understand very specifically your outline. Start with the research design until conclusion. We have a lot of research flow process. We need to learn and learn and learn. Okay, from our class, any questions? Sorry, any question to question it on mixed methods? Okay, ada soalan tak nak tanya mixed method? So this one another, for example, critical different in three type of survey research. So we have exploratory, descriptive, and explanatory. So this table also increase our understanding to know that what is meaning that exploratory, what is meaning is explanatory, what is descriptive. So they go through, start from unit analysis, clear and defined. So this descriptive, clear, defined, and appropriate the research question. So explanatory, okay, is clear, defined, and appropriate for the research question and hypothesis. So because explanatory mostly on quantitative, you need to test the hypothesis, and that's why from the hypothesis can answer research question. Okay, this is some of the differentiate from three types. Let's go through the elements. And kalau respondent represent of the unit analysis. Represent of unit analysis also from descriptive, what explanatory represent of the unit analysis. So, sama lah. And okay, I open question. Kalau ada soalan nak tanya, silakan. Okay, DDR. DDR actually, you can apply mixed method. No problems. You can apply DDR. So, I cannot say that DDR is mixed method. No, DDR is tools. DDR only tools. In order to do a research, I apply DDR tool. Okay. In order to using the DDR tool, I apply mixed method research. Okay. If you want to study DDR only using quantitative, also accept. You want to study DDR on qualitative, also accept. You want to study DDR untuk mixed method, still accept. You want to study DDR for the mixed method, also accept. DDR only tools, just only tools. But you want to study on the mixed method, you need to start based on your philosophical. So my research actually applied combination on the positivism and interpretism. In order to answer my objective and research question, I applied both inductive and deductive. So from the explanation on that, so from to method to answer all this, so from the previous study, I'm using DDR tool. Okay, no problem. DDR tool actually a set of tools. So we have a lot of tools, not just only DDR. So some of study using ISM as a tool, using AHP as a tools, using on the simulation as a tool, using product design prototype as another tools. So a lot of the tools. So DDR only a tools. So this is not research strategy. So DDR is not research strategy. DDR is a tools. Alan. Okay. But if you ask me, can DDI using mixed method? Yes. If you ask me, which DDR is mixed method? No. Can DDI apply mixed method? Yes. Another different thing. So DDR bukan mixed method, but DDR tool can apply or can using mixed method research. Boleh. Okay, ada soalan lain? Takkan go through dua lah. For example, okay, maybe next week we try to cover still in mixed method. I need to cover mixed method because in mixed method we cover three actually. We cover quali, we cover quanti, and we cover combination quali and quantitative. I need to cover also specifically maybe 1 week. Next week, not next week, like following weeks, following next week. So we cover on the population and sampling on the research. Yeah? I'm cover mixed method lah. So in mixed method, we cover both. When we cover mixed method, we can discuss what the population recommended or suitable for quantitative research and qualitative research and mixed method research. Okay, ada soalan? If you don't have questions, or to like our attendant also not really good lah, and still we still not good numbers to join our class. I hope so everyone is fine. And we still face the COVID-19 issues, but I believe that our education needs still moving forwards. And so because this is for you in order to make it clear and understanding, and then how to write your thesis. So in our class is business research method. So This week and following week, so a lot of topic is about the methods, and we need to recover in methodology. So part of analysis, yeah, you need to go to another class to cover on the analysis class. But I think right now I need to increase your knowledge time to time, sorry, week by week, the topic on the methodology. So how that you can get detail, it's not detail lah, you can get more and more about the methodology on the research. So that's why we straight away we go to the example from the thesis, that because going to familiar and we can be related and assist you in write, and especially to write through the outline or to write based on the paragraph and go through perenggan demi perenggan. So you know that how to make very good paragraph in chapter 3 specifically, because we cover on methodology. Okay, ada soalan?
Doctor, I'm Chai. I just want to check regarding this assignment. Yes.
Okay, yes.
Yeah, because I'm doing this template and matrix at this moment.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think got something I need to fill in. I'm not really sure what is the answer I should, because I'm also studying some of the journal.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'm looking. I work for this chapter 2 literature review.
Yeah.
And then they have this 2.5 conceptual definition. I'm not really sure what should I fill in for that.
What section?
Chapter 2 literature review, 2.5 conceptual definition.
Conceptual framework, conceptual definitions.
Yes, conceptual definition.
Conceptual is something like this. Okay, in research, we start with the basic knowledge. Some basic knowledge, we start with the theory. So in theory is not enough. And as a research, as in your reality, your life, theory is not enough. So to become reality, so we face on the governments, we know that our socials, our technology, our industry, our economic. So you need to balance. In order to only read article, journal and thesis for the theoretical perspective, you need to also write on the conceptual. So a lot of conceptual from model economy, from model industry, from the community, from local and overseas, can be also support for your theoretical. So the conceptual definition is represent, you need to explain concept. And you need to explain concept that related in your studies to support your theoretical frameworks. So that's why if you just covered on the theoretical perspective only, so your thesis may be a domination by academic and theory only. But thesis is not only on academic. Thesis is about the, for example, that mixed method. They mentioned that if you are study mixed method, meaning that you are covered worldwide. So you are actually no structured. You should have flexibility and subjectively. So you can explore many tools, you can explore many measures, you can apply many many methods, many instruments in order to make sure that your objective and research question can be answered intelligently, because this method, they're using word intelligently. Okay, so that the reason lah. So purposely, I think that the specific keywords, conceptual definition, you not need to write in your thesis the conceptual definition, but in your thesis should be conceptual framework or concept. So you can start write in your literature review. Initially, you need to write on the concept. What concept are most suitable in your thesis? Finally, you can come up, you can propose on the conceptual framework. Okay, back to our assignments from the literature review matrix. So yes, we already explained. That's why you need to listening again from the video based on the template on literature. So I already highlight that. So this is actually the long templates. So some of the factors, maybe you need to write none. It's meaning that it's not related. It's actually some of the your article, based on your article reading, is not related because this portion is not explained. For example, theory. Based on this article, not explained what theory that used from these studies, not mentioned. So you need to write an R or an M, not mentioned, or something like that. So I just give a long factors categorized, but you can cut off, you can simplify by using little bits from that templates. Okay, from the assignments, for me is nothing fault and wrong. Sorry, nothing is about perfect and wrong. This is about how you learn using the templates. Okay, I believe that from this exploration on the template, you can learn something because you try to understand what is meaning on theory, what's meaning on the variable, what meaning about teams, what is the sampling technique, what is the sampling size. So in this method of template, you can explore and try to get some knowledge and understanding to tackle of that. Okay, so don't worry about the template. So I don't see the perfectionist or fault or wrong, true or false, sorry. That is the most important thing, that how you can apply from this metric can assist, can guide you in order to write one paragraph in your thesis. Because for me, if I want to write in one paragraph, I need the metric. So if I don't have the metric, I cannot be easily to write in one paragraph. Okay, so the templates itself, the metric itself is a tool for me. It's a tool to me to write the one paragraph. Then I hope so that this metrics literature will be one of your research tool in order to complete and your chapter by chapter. Suddenly you finish your thesis by using this literature review matrix. Okay, something like that. We try to make it simplified, but when we read a lot of thesis and article, a lot of the term they're using, but it, when you ask me about the conceptual definition, is represent that you need to explain what concept they use. If you're using the model A, that you need to explain what is a model A. Why this study using more than one? Mostly it's more than one. For example, you're using five concept. Why you need to integrate five concept in this study? So you need to explain and give justify on this. So explain and justify actually are most important rather than definitions. Because in literature review, we not just only cover the definition, but the most important thing, how you discuss and justify. Okay, any questions?
Not for me, thank you.
All right. Thank you, Chai. So dekat bahagian chat pun tak ada soalan. Okay, it's okay. Thank you very much your time and commitments. So be ready 10 p.m. I think I need to stop our class and discussion on the mixed method. Please remember next week we have another topic on the mixed methods. Okay, I'm trying to cover another things, the difference, something different with today, because today mostly on philosophy approach, and then research strategy, little bit on the time horizon, that maybe next week I try to cover another things in our methodology we need to cover also, and in order to complete on the chapter 3. Okay, remind again, make sure because this subject is about audit class, audit course, so the result is only pass or fails. So in order to get the pass, please complete the assignment. So try to complete based on your progress. Not necessary you need to write perfect. So if you are still in semester one, please try whatever you have done and what is actually. But I need three chapters: chapter one, chapter two, chapter three. How many page? Doesn't matter. But I need three chapters to show that this is your progress from this class. You can show your progress. You can write little bit, or you can write several on chapter one, chapter two, and chapter three. And then please explore the templates. And also because this class also requirement, you need to present because the pandemic issues, I need you ready the video to present on your proposal. Okay. Okay. In this matter, please see your sorry. Please see the last video. Okay? So last video we highlight again what you should do in your assignment. Thank you very much. Okay, I think we need to stop. Okay, thank you for your comment. I'm sorry if I make it wrong to explain about the mixed method. Okay, thank you again. See you next week. Assalamualaikum and selamat sejahtera.
Baring kat sebelah.